Welcome back. It's a big day for the Cox Science Center and Aquarium in West Palm Beach, a groundbreaking for a multi-million dollar expansion set to happen.
Yeah, joining us is First Morning Meteorologist Sandra Shaw with the president and CEO there. Sandra, just about 45 minutes or so away from this groundbreaking.
Yes, and I got a preview of the speech, and it sounds incredible. No, we are so excited. $115 million plus expansion, right, Kate?
Absolutely.
And so it's going to triple in size? Is that right?
We are. We are going from 25,000 square feet of exhibit space to 75,000 square feet of exhibit space. We are tripling the fun that you have here at the Cox Science Center and Aquarium.
One of my favorite things is the aquarium. Tell us about what's going to happen with that.
Well, I'm glad you're saying that, because in all of our research, we realized that people really wanted to see an expanded aquarium.
Yeah.
So if you like the aquarium now, it's about 10,000 gallons. The aquarium that we're building is 130,000 gallons. It will be one of the largest aquariums in the state, the Kenneth C. Griffin Aquarium, and we know people will drive from all over to see this incredible attraction.
Do you know what sort of marine life's going to be in there?
Oh, we do. We're going to have a shark tank that's going to be so big.
I knew you were going to say
that. Our marine biologists are going to be able to get inside and swim around and talk to the visitors in the gallery real time with our specialized equipment.
Oh, that is wild.
We're going to have sharks raised, stingrays, jellyfish, coral, real coral. We're going to talk about coral conservation. So there really is going to be everything, including a large portion on the Florida Everglades and the River of Grass.
There's so much here. I mean, we really are ground zero for so much when it comes to climate change, when it comes to ecology and everything. What other sorts of things that you have? You also do coding. You do have the chess club. What's this going to allow you to do more of?
Well, it really is going to allow us to reach so many more visitors than we do now. We will be the number one ticketed attraction in Palm Beach County post-expansion, and we will reach almost a million visitors a year through our doors and with our outreach program. We've never been able to do that before. We're going to have a traveling exhibit hall so large that we will be able to bring in international exhibits here to Palm Beach County. We're giving Palm Beach County what it truly deserves, which is one of the best science centers in the nation.
And I heard you say in the speech earlier that you really want to reach everybody. We have a lot of underserved here, and you know, we want to have access for everyone. Why is that such a mission for you?
Because we're here for everyone. We're a community-based science center. We are here no matter your income, no matter your age, no matter your socioeconomic status. Our mission is to open every mind to science, and we have ways to do that. We'll have free Fridays. We have a program called Museums for All. We do free veterans. So there really is no barriers for everyone experiencing this incredible organization.
And this is kind of an overall question, but why science? Why do we need to elevate science at this time in human history?
That's a great question. For our country to stay competitive economically, we need people in STEM, science, technology, engineering, mathematics. 8 out of the 10 fastest growing jobs in this country focus on STEM. We need graduates to focus. We need to make the penny drop when they're in 4th, 5th, and 6th grade so that they go on and they have careers in these fields. And that's exactly what we do here. We make the light bulb go off here at the Cox Science Center.
There's a passion when you actually get that hands-on experience.
There's
no doubt about it.
So much. The mind remembers what the hands have touched. And that's what we do here.
I love it. Thank you so much,
Thank
Kate.
You.
Amazing interview. All right. Well, we are here, and that is the latest from the Cox Science Center. Back to you guys.